Good afternoon and welcome to St. Mary's Perivale. Great to have you with us. We've got a keen audience here. The church is almost full this afternoon for a cello and piano recital by two wonderful musicians, Yoanna Prodanova and Ariel Lanyi, and both have played here several times before. Both are superb. You can read about them on the website. Their biogs are there, as is the programme for this afternoon, which is basically Schubert's Arpeggione, wonderful piece written for a funny instrument that only lasted about 10 years and became obsolete, but all cellists have played it ever since, as of various other instruments. And then we have a Fauré cello sonata, and then a Strauss cello sonata. So three sonatas. You're in for a treat. I'm going to ask our audience here to put their hands together and give a warm welcome.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us here today. It's such a pleasure to be back in this beautiful place. Thank you, Hugh, for having us.
Pleasure.
And thank you for having me. I think first time I was here was about 9 years ago, so time really flies. We asked each other what we should say, and we said we'll improvise. So I thought, what's the link between these three seemingly very different composers? And the first thought that I had was that all of them wrote extensively for a voice. Of course, all the Schubert Lieder and Fauré wrote so many songs, and Strauss with his incredible operas and songs. And actually there is a bit in the second movement, at the end of the second movement, which Ariel always says that it reminds him of a place, a particular place in one of the four last songs.
Yes.
Yeah.
Just about that. What I find most remarkable, specifically about the Strauss Sonata, is the way in which it almost links to his very last works. So the Sonata was written when he was, I think, a teenager. It's Opus 6, so we're talking very, very early Strauss. And the outer movements, both in F major, have this very optimistic and youthful, exuberant feeling emanating almost from every bar. But the middle movement is a lot more wistful and sometimes even funereal. And it's in D minor. But at the end, we have a theme in D major which really gives us the sense that, you know, something has opened in a much higher sphere than ours. And it is the same key as September from the four last songs, the second of the four last songs, which is his very last piece, which he wrote in his 80s. And you really get the sense that he was already thinking about these things as a teenager. And he had all those decades in between.
Another interesting fact about that piece, sorry to make it all cello, but it was written for Hans Wihan, who was a great Czech cellist. And 11 years later, the Dvorak cello concerto was dedicated to him as well, which for me, it seems like Wihan really wanted to play the most amazing tunes because the Strauss Sonata is just full of them, and so is the Dvorak concerto. And also, something else to be super grateful for to Strauss is that he wrote even more for cello later, one of the biggest masterpieces we have, the Don Quixote for cello, viola, and orchestra. So he must have liked the instruments. And what about the Fauré?
The Fauré is a very late piece, unlike the Strauss, is quite close to the end of his life. It's Opus 117. And it was written after the First World War, when I think Fauré was also losing his hearing, and it's almost perverse in its simplicity, in the sense that everything is so clearly presented, and all the harmonic clashes, of which there are so many, are all presented in an almost naive sense of sweetness, which might be false, might be true, we don't know. I'm talking mainly about the first movement. And the second movement was originally intended as a funeral march for Napoleon. That's not exactly right. It was intended to commemorate the anniversary, the 100th anniversary of Napoleon's death. And it was intended to mark that occasion. So we hear this almost the rhythm, almost of a funeral march. But as you will hear, it's quite different from that.
Good. Well done.
These concerts do have an air of informality, which is part of their charm. Thank you. You both did very well. Let's give them a round of applause. Well, that was an exceptional recital. What wonderful pieces and what wonderful playing. I didn't know that Strauss before. What a great piece. The whole thing was played quite wonderfully well by two superb musicians. Privileged to be here, really. So if you've enjoyed it from afar, if you think it's as good as we thought it was, please think of going to our website and donating to support them. The musicians get all the money, we don't get anything. So please help to keep these concerts going. There's no concert on Sunday because of the Platinum Jubilee. There's a piano recital on Tuesday by Kenny Fu, a wonderful pianist. And so it goes on. Thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. The technician upstairs is Andrew Wadcote. The box office, my dear wife, Felicity Mather. And thank you very much for being with us on a superb afternoon. Thank you very much, and good afternoon from West London.